Hello and welcome to the year-end real estate statistics for Ottawa for 2021. Patrick Walchuk here, and if you enjoy getting these videos, click on the subscribe button and we'll send them out to you every month. So looking at what happened in the month of December, comparing it to December of the year before for all of Ottawa, this is what went on. In December, we had 557 homes sell, and that was a decline of 22%. Breaking that up into condos and freeholds, so for freehold, there were 317 homes sell, and that was a massive decline of 27% over December of the previous year. Condominiums, 240 sales, that's 240, and that's a decline of 15%. Now, the average price of a property for both condo and freehold was $618,000, and that's an increase over December of last year by 13%. Freeholds were selling for $783,000, and that's an increase of 17%. And condos sold on average for about $399,000. And that's an increase of 11% over December of 2020. Now, in terms of how long it was taking for a home to sell in December, they were selling in 18 days. And that's 5% faster than the year before. And condominiums, they were selling in 28 days compared to 24 last year. Now, part of what's been driving the market all year, quite frankly, is a lack of inventory. December was no different in terms of the listings that were available for sale. There were 535 freehold homes for sale, and that's at the end of the month, and that's a decline of 14% over December of last year. Condominiums, there were only, get this, 199 for sale, and that was a huge decline of 41% over December of last year. So now we'll move on to the various neighborhoods, the major neighborhoods. So looking at Orleans for the month of December of 2021, we'll show you the sales and prices. And if you enjoy getting these videos about Orleans, click on the subscribe button. We'll send them out to you every month. So in December, there were 79 homes that traded hands in Orleans, down from 99 in December of the previous year. When you break that out into freehold and condos, for freehold, there were 54 homes sell, which is a decrease of 24%. And for condominiums, we had 25 of them sell, and that was a small decline of about 11% over the previous year. Now, in terms of prices, for freehold homes, the average price in Orleans in December was $678,000, which was a decline of an increase in price of 16%. So unit sales were down, but prices were up by 16%. Condominiums, $388,000, and that was a pretty substantial increase of 18%. And it took 19 days for a home to sell in Orleans in December compared to 15 days last year. So for Barrhaven, if you enjoy getting this information about the Barrhaven real estate market, click on the subscribe button. We'll send it out to you at the beginning of every month. What went on in Barrhaven is that there were 57 homes that traded hands, and that was a decline of 32% over December of 2020. Breaking that out into freehold and condos, 44 freehold homes sold, and that's a decrease of 38% over last year. Condominiums, there were only 13 sell, and that's exactly the same number that sold in December of 2020 as well. Looking at the prices, same story in December is what's been going on the rest of the year. The price, the average price in Barrhaven was $749,000. That was an increase of 20%. And for condominiums, the average price, called it $430,000. And that was an increase of 22%. So unit sales down, prices up, lack of inventory is the cause. And in terms of how long it was taking to sell, they were selling on 13 days on average. So moving on to Kanata. If you enjoy getting these videos about the Kanata real estate market, click on the subscribe button. We'll send them out to you every month. So for the month of December, compared to the month of December of 2020, this is what went on in Kanata. There were 56 homes sell. That was a decline of 20% over December of last year. Now, breaking that out into freehold and condos, there were 46 freehold sales, which was a decrease of 19%. For condominiums, very small numbers, but there were 10 sales, and that's compared to 13 the year prior to that. In terms of prices, wow. So unit sales down, listen to this price. Freehold sales, $809,000 was the average price. That was a huge increase of 33% compared to December of last year. For condominiums, it's even more interesting. Average price, $469,000 to buy a condo in Kanata. That's an increase of 35% over the previous year. And in terms of how long it was taking to sell, they were selling in 13 days compared to 11 days. You know, December, things are really, really quiet. Nothing's moving, right? Well, they were moving and they were selling for record prices and they were selling in only 13 days. So thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, give me a call.